One of the first times where I really started to think about the inner workings of dating apps was when I was at a conference plenary and heard the co-founder of OkCupid explain the matching and the sorting and how people are ranked and put together. Christian Rutter, the co-founder of OkCupid, said, "You know, if you feel like your matches are ugly, it's probably because you're ugly." And you know, people sort of gave some nervous laughter. And he went on to say that people are going to be ranked according to their level of attractiveness and then match within those brackets. If you are a 5 or a 6, then for the most part, if you're using a dating app, you're gonna see 5s and 6s. What we know is that when a user uploads their photo to any dating platform, a system is going to evaluate their attractiveness by comparing them to other users who are already on the platform. And that sort of just made me think, who is creating these brackets? Where do they come from? And none of these apps would respond to my emails when I came knocking, which was not a surprise. And from there, I realized I'm gonna have to really be creative about understanding what goes into constructing the user experience. One of my colleagues had the brilliant idea of looking for patents. I just Googled Tinder. And I looked at all the results, and there was one in particular that jumped out at me, and it was called something about a matching and sorting system. Empirical data indicates that people are more likely to match with people of similar attractiveness. The huge thing that they're not saying, though, is that most people who are not white would never be considered a 10 by dating platforms' algorithms. People who are outliers, the sort of almost nice way of saying unattractive, are folks who don't fit within that framework. So larger bodies, people whose faces are not ideally symmetrical, people who are brown. Dating platforms really take away the agency of users. They're not giving us the ability to opt out. And I think that that's unfair for users, especially when it's about who we might spend the rest of our lives with, who we might have children with. And we really need dating platforms to be more responsible, to be more transparent about how they are selecting who ends up on our screen, and ultimately giving us the choice to make more informed choices about our partners.